Hey there, Dan at danliberto.com, where we are improving influence and reaching a greater potential. You know, when I left the corporate environment into a small business owner, one of the transitions that was the most difficult for me was transitioning from the mindset of an employee to an employer or business owner. And, you know, part of that mindset was that you're exchanging time for money. So as a small business owner, you're no longer doing that. You're basically building value. You're building value in the marketplace. So a lot of your efforts have to be income producing or moving you toward income producing. And so this was a real challenge for me. How do you focus? How do you get control of the management of your time? And so that's what I want to chat with you today. So some key things, some things that'll help you manage your time a little bit better and get more focused on income producing things, or at least things that are supporting income producing things. What I mean by that is moving people into the sales funnel, so to speak, getting them closer, getting them to understand and know you a little bit better, to know, like, and trust you as a person that they might want to grow with, a person they might want to do business with. So the first thing I will mention to you in this whole concept of managing your time is, if you haven't done a time audit of what you're doing, do so. Reach out to me, personal message me. I'll be happy to send you a little manual audit sheet where you can basically manage what it is or audit what you're doing with your time in 15-minute increments. And that'll be a real eye-opener for you as to what it is you're actually spending your time on. So I would highly recommend that. There's also automated tools that are apps that you could download on your phone, like Toggle, that'll help you basically do an audit of your time. But I'd highly recommend that because, you know, we all have so much energy that we expel on a daily basis, and we're gonna burn up that energy doing one thing or another. It would be quite a surprise to you, I'll bet, when you identify what it is you're actually expending that energy on. So reach out to me, personal message me. I'll be happy to send you that audit and some more information on how you can audit your time. But the things I want to talk to you about here is, just real quickly, the first one is, in any day, and this is something you would plan for the week, you have the whole concept, and maybe you've heard of this concept, maybe you haven't, but you have the concept of your big rocks. So what are those things that are important, things that have to get done? And I want to be very clear here. I'm not just talking about things that are urgent, because a lot of times what we do is we procrastinate, we put things off until they become urgent. And so big rocks really should be those things that are important. So if you're planning for a big speech in a couple of weeks, that should be on your calendar, doing whatever you need to be doing, that little bit of prep in advance each and every day, because it's important. You are going to stand in front of people and you're going to deliver value. And to do that, you have to be properly prepared. Or if that, you know, maybe you're doing a presentation for your boss or a customer, a sales presentation. Again, the important thing is that it is a big rock, because that sales meeting is something that is income producing. So those big rocks need to be on your calendar, and they need to go on your calendar first and foremost. And again, the illustration here is, you know, if I had a bucket full of big rocks and small rocks, if I put the small rocks in first, I'd have real difficult time fitting in all the big rocks, which are really the important things in our life. But if I took that bucket and I filled them with the big rocks first, what we find out is the small rocks will fill in the cracks and the crevices that the big rocks create. And so there's room for both. So start with the big rocks. Those are the important things in your life, in your day, in your week. Identify all the big rocks. Put those on your calendar first and foremost. Put them at a time. The second thing is your small rocks, those things that aren't as important, but they still need to get done. And so those things are the second thing that you would put on your calendar. Your small rocks can be stuff like stopping at the grocery store, or making sure you mail that letter. It's not necessarily urgent, But, you know, things like that that are just small, they're things that you want to get that done today, but if you don't get them done today or this week, you know, the world doesn't come to an end. But those are your small rocks. Those are the things that you want to put second on the list. And then the last thing I would mention to you is once you have these things on your calendar, once you have the big rocks first and then your small rocks on your calendar, then block off that time. By blocking off that time, number one, you're going to create a discipline where on a regular basis, you're going to go and you're going to do something. You're going to, you know, review your calendar. Your calendar is your boss. Blocking off the time will also identify for you any free time you might have for other important things, other big rocks that you might want to fit into your day or your week. So there's my quick lesson on time organization. If you institute those three techniques in your daily and weekly and monthly planning, you'll find yourself a lot more productive. And if you do the time audit, you will see exactly how much time you have. We're all busy, but busy doesn't necessarily mean we're productive. So drop me a note. I'd like to get your take on this. Which one of these techniques are you going to try first? Are you going to lock down your big rocks or your small rocks or calendar blocking? Or are you going to do all three? Drop me a note. Let me know. If this was beneficial to you, feel free to share it to somebody that might benefit as well. And of course, as always, I'd appreciate it if you would like my page. Other than that, dan@danliberto.com. Rooting for you, for myself and all small business owners. Have a great day. Bye now.